I think by now we know about the Jurassic Park, or now the Jurassic World series. I prefer calling it Jurassic Park, but which one you prefer? I think Universal prefers Jurassic World, mainly because, we can get into the whole, I'm getting into the whole rights thing a different time. But anyways, we all know by now, these movies are about, mainly the first one, was about humans creating clones of dead dinosaurs and trying to bring them back to life and putting them in a theme park setting, and eventually the electricity and power goes out during the storm. Or actually, yeah, I'm not gonna tell the whole story if you haven't watched Jurassic Park by now, but eventually, spoiler alert, the dinosaurs break out and start eating some of the people inside the park. Mainly this just happens in Jurassic Park and Jurassic World. The other, what is it now? How many Jurassic Parks is it now? Like five? So, I can't even do math. Three out of the five, the other ones, they just keep going back to the island or try to, you get my what I'm saying. But as we all know, these dinosaurs weren't real. Okay. They were, well, mainly the T-Rex from the first one was a life-size animatronics. So, question is, whatever happened to those T-Rex animatronics that were used in the first one? And also a little bit, whatever happened to the Spinosaurus animatronic that was actually used in Jurassic Park 3? Get to the answer about that. Now, there were two life-size, almost life-size T-Rex animatronics constructed by the late great Stan Winston and his studios. They was to be used on sound stages for filming the attack from the T-Rex on the Ford Explorers in the first one, that famous scene that we all know with the T-Rex with the water rumbling, and you get what I'm saying. Since there was two, there was one for, there was one actually 37 feet long, full size animatronic, and the second was a more precision and had more, a little bit more detail to it for close ups. Mainly for the window scenes. And it was controlled by a telemetry device. And they also were paying. Mainly that 37 foot bigger one. Now the process of building these impressive machines can be an own video itself, because it took a lot of time and planning and scaling and drawing to actually put that thing into like what you wanted to look like before you actually built the actual machine. And it's a lot of stuff that I probably won't cover in this video, but I'll try to